right around the corner from football season starting, as far as I'm concerned, when you know, the summertime hits,
start
to think about training camp, and before you know it, so things will be flying at M&T Bank Stadium. For 18 years, Dick Cass was the president of the Baltimore Ravens, and he's retired, and we have a new team president who joins us in studio this morning.
Great to have him in.
Sashi Brown is here. Great to have you. Appreciate your time.
Good morning. Thanks. Thanks for having me.
I think there's a thousand different things I want to get into, but the title of team president, right, it means a lot of different things depending on the organization, right? You've got player contracts, you've got cap room, you've got lawyer stuff, things to do. You maybe hire, fire coaches. What exactly do you do for the Baltimore Ravens?
We're still trying to figure that out. Still writing the job description. No, when I come in, you know, every day is different. And we've got a great staff. Dick Cass, as you mentioned him, left the organization in tremendous space. We've got a really talented executive team. You all know the folks on the football operations side. They're really good at what they do. You know, primarily, I liaison with the NFL and just support our people in-house. And to the end that I can dive in on any strategic initiatives, something like, you know, the investment we'll make in M&T Bank Stadium, I'll spend a little more time on those types of topics. But generally, on a day-to-day basis, trying to make sure that I'm supporting the people doing their jobs.
The president of the Baltimore Ravens is joining us in studio right now, Sashi Brown. Just to give a little background on you, Sashi. You're a Harvard Law School graduate. You have been working with Mr. Cass in the legal realm before you came here, and 13 years of NFL experience. Just in what you've gone through before coming to the Ravens, just how does that help you or inform you at executive vice president of football operations? How does that inform you when you come here?
Yeah, I've had a wealth of experience from, you know, training at the law firm and really getting great professional training here at Wilmer, where Dick and I first met way back in 2002, to my time at the Jaguars and the Browns, and then certainly the time I had over at Monumental Sports down the road in D.C. with the Wizards and the Mystics and you know, their initiatives back at the headquarters of Monumental Sports and Entertainment. All those experiences gave me different perspectives and opportunities to grow, and you know, a lot of I think versatility that I bring to, you know, this role. I've done things on the team operations side, certainly have led a lot of work on business operations side as well, and so being able to combine those experiences, the skill set that you develop is really important, and it allows me to, you know, have I think great insights into what a tremendous organization and professional sports organization looks like and how they run and how they maintain that excellence that the Ravens have been known for.
So when you look at this organization and where it is today and where you want it to go 5 years from now, 10 years from now, what gets you excited? What are we looking at as fans, as citizens of Baltimore?
Yeah, I think the first thing is Eric and John and Ozzy before Eric have put the organization, the team, in such a great place. You know, they have a really strong culture, some really young players who are going to be here for a long period of time, be able to compete at a high level. So the first thing we want to be about every day is football, right? Mm-hmm. And you know, a big piece of that is driving what has been and will continue to be the greatest fan experience in the NFL and one of the greatest fan experiences in sports. And so, you know, I referenced it earlier, but we're excited to be working with Maryland Stadium Authority and thank them for, you know, and the state for the commitment to reinvest significant dollars into the stadium and modernize it. And so those are all things that we'll be working on as we move forward to make sure that both our experience on the field and what fans see in terms of the product on the field, but also their experience in the stadium when they come down to watch down at the bank.
Any nuggets that you can give us about what we could possibly do, you know, at the Ravens Stadium in the next couple of years that will be different from what we do now?
No, you guys have to pay for that.
Got to pull the curtain back and pay for that one, huh? Sashi Brown is on board with us, president of the Baltimore Ravens. And I always share the experience, Sashi, that in 1996 when the Ravens first came here, and there was no Ravens name. It was just the late Art Modell, his son David Modell. And I was in the legislature at the time. We were all down at Ground, which is now a stadium, but Ground, a parking lot, talking about it, that Art Modell said, we're going to be a great corporate citizen. And immediately he put a multi-million-dollar check into Johns Hopkins and their cancer research. And since then, and Dick Cass, the member of Greater Baltimore Committee, Kennedy Krieger, do you see yourself also, you know, integrating that, being keeping that great corporate citizenship up with the city of Baltimore?
Yeah, absolutely. The Ravens, that is one of our three main goals. I mentioned the other two, which is great football, a great fan experience, but also, you know, a great impact and positive impact on the community here of Greater Baltimore. So we absolutely will make that a focus, and I'll be personally involved in a lot of that. We're already working on a few initiatives, nothing I can talk about today. Okay. I know I'm getting ready to be
asked. Break some news.
Yes, I preempted that a little bit. But no, we'll continue to be, you know, involved in the community, and there's a number of programs that are ongoing annual for us, but there'll also be some big strategic initiatives that we'll launch.
So to the football team, there is OTAs going on right now, which are voluntary, but the quarterback of the football team, who a lot of people want to sign a new contract but hasn't signed a new contract, was not there. How big of a deal is that? As Ravens fans, should we be concerned about that? Should that tell us that something's not right with the relationship between the team and the player? What's going on, Sashi?
No, voluntary does mean voluntary, and that's true. And I think, you know, Lamar's been out working this offseason. Eric and John talked about it. So no, I don't think any reason for alarm. And he's been very vocal in terms of Lamar, in terms of his support and desire to be in Baltimore. So we're pleased that he's out there working and not going to make a big deal out of this.
One of the things that was concerning to many of us last year, Sashi Brown, president of Baltimore Ravens, is all the injuries, all the times we look up and see our players not being able to play. Do you feel, and even Coach Harbaugh talked about this, that we really have put some different things in place from strength, conditioning, things like that to really keep them as healthy as possible?
Yeah, I think the organization does a great job, you know, year in, year out of kind of examining itself and trying to get better. And they do that on a day-in, day-out basis. But certainly after the season, I think John and Eric sat down and looked and talked about some of the changes that they can make to hopefully prevent some of those injuries. Some of them just aren't avoidable. We clearly got bit by a bug last year that was kind of that 100-year flood.
The most in the NFL.
Yeah, yeah. You know. And historically, it was really relevant. So it was just unfortunate circumstances. So I think, you know, as we get a lot of key pieces back this year, healthy Ronnie, Marlon, and others, we're really going to, you know, be able to come back out and be the Ravens that we saw. And I give credit, I've said this a number of times, I think the job that John did last year to keep that team competitive and competing into weeks, you know, the late weeks, last week of the season, having an opportunity to make the playoffs with all the injuries they have was unbelievable. One of the better coaching jobs I think I've ever seen.
I agree.
So you with the Wizards, but again, as C4 said, Jacksonville and Cleveland. So you've been in the NFL and then, you know, working with the Wizards, you were also with Masson. So you know the entertainment aspect of it. I am curious as to know where you think the NFL can go, big picture wise, because I mean the NFL is still is king of all sports in this country. I mean, people love the NFL. The ratings are through the roof. But what can it do to get even better? What do you see as something that the NFL needs to do to either make the experience better for fans, make it better on television, or how it can grow the sport even?
You know, the league spends, and we were just down in Atlanta talking about this quite a bit, the league spends a lot of time trying to make sure that as we all, you know, spend more time on these devices, that we provide our content and we meet our fans where they're going to be. So more and more people are unplugging from cable. So we've got a lot of strategic initiatives that are around, you know, kind of meeting our fans where they are. And I think we've done a good job at that as around the league. And even at the Ravens, I think we do a tremendous job. You know, Ravens.com and Michelle and her group, you know, and our team do an awesome job producing content and making sure that the type of content that we get so that people can stay engaged with the Ravens 365 days a year. I also think one of the things that we'll see, and we've got five games this year, international games, mm-hmm. you know, can we bring the game over in a sustainable way overseas? And that's a real opportunity. And also here, you know, in Mexico, you know, the fervor for NFL football down in Mexico is awesome. And people don't really realize this, but the Ravens have a strong following
really?
In Mexico City. Yeah. Uh-huh. And so we have a lot of digital engagement in Mexico City. And so we're excited about that. Applauding the Eagles, the first team that's going to have a affiliation with in Ghana. And they've got the marketing
I saw
rights
that.
Over there. So there's some exciting things coming. And as you all know, that we're seeing more and more players who are, you know, maybe not immediately from overseas, but first generation folks that are coming here and playing at a really high level. We've got a couple of them on our defensive line.
Are you hinting at a Ravens Mexico City game next year? Is that what that is?
I am not.
Here we go.
I am not.
He's going to get one of those questions in here.
We're going to have to talk after this.
Sashi, I do want to ask you though, because, you know, no knock on where you've been, but here, I call us most spoiled fans almost in the NFL. We win. We've been winning a long time since that move into Baltimore. Yeah. Do you feel that? Do you feel like the expectations are just higher? And that, yeah, I'm going to say spoiled fans. You just expect to win.
We want that. it's a tremendous legacy. So first, and hats off to Ozzie and Brian Billick and Steve Bisciotti and Modell and John Harbaugh, all of whom Eric DaCosta contributed in big ways to that winning tradition here. And it's not to be taken lightly, but I can tell you those guys are competitive. You know, they're just not resting on the laurels. They're hungry. They want to get after it every day and get better every day. And so, you know, the culture that they've built, the talent level that's in the building.
It's a great draft class for you to walk into. This draft class was awesome.
It was good. Eric did an awesome job. Eric and his team and Joe, I mean, they were really, really strong. And you know, they were both thorough and strategic. So I was really pleased. I think everybody was what we were able to accomplish over those 3 days. Mm.
I think we're so lucky in Baltimore to have this franchise. I mean, I honestly think it's one of the shining, you know, things that this city exports is football and the franchise, the way it's run. I am curious from your point of view. Look, I don't mean this disrespectfully, but the Browns and the Jaguars and the Wizards, I mean, that's low end of the totem pole on success in the last decades. The Ravens have had that success. Have you noticed the difference in the different organizations? You know that you've been. I know you've only been here for a couple months, but have you seen anything that is different?
Yeah, we certainly. I think as you come into the building, the expectations are there, and you know there's a confidence that goes with that. Now, you know, I'll say, and I'm a competitive guy, you know, there were some days that the Jaguars rolled in here and put some tattoos on some butts.
Yeah, true. Okay.
I lived those days.
Fair enough.
I lived those days. I was Browns, in the stands
so
on those
much.
Days.
Browns, yeah. Not so much, but we had some Big Hen and Stroud and Maurice Jones-Drew.
Right.
But those were fun times. And this was actually one of the great rivalries. So, you know, there's a couple teams that come into your stadium that you know you need to be ready and have your hard hat on that day. And, you know, the Ravens are one of those teams. It doesn't matter where they are, they're going to be prepared, they're going to play hard, and we'll continue that.
Well, I can see that much like Mr. Dick Cass, you're very soft-spoken, you're going to be probably very, you know, behind the scenes, but what should fans expect from President, finally, final question, from President Sashi Brown of the Ravens? Who are you?
Oh, I think, you know, the big thing is we're going to continue to, you know, be humble as an organization, collaborative, really support and keep football at the forefront. Be invested in this community, and that's what you'll see from us.
See, it's soft-spoken.
I know.
Right down to the end.
Very good.
That's what's Harvard. That's what Harvard training.
It was Hampton, right? That's, you know, everybody talks about my grandfather. Talks about Hampton.
My grandfather went to Hampton. My mother's father, Hampton graduate, back in the 1940s.
That's there right. You go. Pirates.
There you go. Yeah. All right. Anyway, thank you, Sashi Brown. Appreciate your time.
Great
being
to
here.
Have you. Really appreciate you. Best of luck to you, too.
Great. Thank you.
I appreciate it. Everybody stay here. More in a moment.